you all. I am Shanmugha Ramanan, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering from Ponjusli College of Engineering. Last class, I taught the general introduction of truss element. Today, I go to teach you the problem based on truss element. What is truss? Truss is a structure made up of a number of bars are riveted or welded together. That is known as truss element. So, truss elements are used in bridges, buildings, etc. For the two bar truss shown in figure, determine the displacement at node 2 and stress in each element. So, as we studied, the point load is act only in the node. That is the assumptions of truss element. In this truss element, there is a three nodes, node 1, 2 and 3. Point load is act in the node 2. And here we go to find the displacement at node 2 and stress in each element. So, given data, Young's modulus and area are given. So, Young's modulus E equal to 70 gigapascal. Giga means 10 to 9. Pascal means Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square is converted into Newton per mm square. That is, Newton per meter square equal to 10 to minus 6 of Newton per mm square. 10 to 9 into 10 to minus 6 is 10 to 3. Therefore, Young's modulus E equal to 70 into 10 to 3 Newton per mm square. Area is given, that is, A equal to 200 mm square. To find displacement at node 2 and stress in each element. First, here we go to draw the free body diagram of given truss element. So, in this truss element, there is a three nodes, node 1, 2 and 3. Node 1 have 2 degrees of freedom, that is U1 and V1. Node 2 have 2 degrees of freedom, U2, V2. Node 3 have 2 degrees of freedom, U3 and V3. Similarly, at node 1, there is two force in x-axis and force in y-axis at node 1. At node 2, force in x-axis, that is F2x, force in y-axis, that is F2y. At node 3, force in x-axis F3x, force in y-axis, that is F3y. So, in this question, the dimensions 500 mm from node 1 to 2 and 400 mm from node 2 to 3 slope. So, here we go to write the reference of this truss element. So, here I make the reference point over here, that is 0, 0. Therefore, node 1 have the reference point in x in y axis x equal to 0 and y axis the distance is 300 mm. Therefore, at node 1 the reference point is 0, 300 in y axis x equal to 0. Y axis length is 300 mm. Therefore, node 1 the reference point is 0, 300. At node 2, from reference point, x axis equal to 500 and y axis equal to 300. Therefore, 500, 300. At node 3, from the reference point, 500 plus 400, 900. In x axis, y equal to 0. Therefore, at node 3, the reference point is 900, 0. So, no, there is a two element, element 1 and element 2. Element 1 have 2 nodes, node 1 and node 2. Element 2 have 2 nodes, node 2 and node 3. So, first for element 1, find the stiffness matrix for element 1. So, here I go to draw the element 1. This is node 1 and 2. That is element 1. The reference point for node 1 is 0, 300. 0, 300. And node 2 have the reference point is 500, 300. And here from 1 to 2, the theta, the angle between node 1 and 2 is 0 degree, that is theta. Stiffness matrix for element 1, the formula is stiffness matrix K equal to A1 E1 by LE1 equal to C1 square C1 S1 minus C1 square minus C1 S1 C1 S1 S1 square minus C1 S1 minus S1 square minus C1 square minus C1 S1 C1 square C1 S1 minus C1 S1 minus S1 square C1 S1 S1 square. Equivalent length LE1 equal to root of X2 minus X1 the whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 the whole square. At node 1, X1 Y1, node 2, X2 Y2, X1 equal to 0, Y1 equal to 0, 300. X2 equal to 500, Y2 equal to 300. Substitute the values, X2 and X1 value, Y2 and Y1 value. Once you simplify this value, equivalent length of element 1 is 500 mm. C1, here we go, next step, here we go to find C1 and S1. There's a two methods for find C1 and S1. The first method, that is C1 equal to cos theta or S1 equal to sin theta. Here the theta value is 0 degree. The angle between node 1 and 2 is 0 degree. Therefore, C1 equal to cos theta, cos 0 equal to 1, therefore C1 equal to 1. Sin 0 equal to 0, therefore S1 equal to 0. So this is one method for find C1 and S1. Another one method for finding C and S are C1 equal to, that's the formula is X2 minus X1 by LE1, S1 equal to Y2 minus Y1 by LE1. So C1 equal to X2 equal to 500, X1 equal to 0 divided by LE1 equal to 500, therefore C1 equal to 1. S1 equal to Y2 minus Y1 by LE1, 300 minus 300, that is 0, 0 divided by any number equal to 0. Therefore, there is a two method for finding C1 and S1 by using theta and by using the reference points, X values and Y. The next step, here we go to substitute the corresponding values, that is K equal to A1, that is the area of element 1 is 200, Young's modulus equal to 70 into 10 cube, LE1 equal to 500. And substitute the values of C1 square equal to 1 square, that is 1. Then CS equal to 0. CS equal to 0. S1 square equal to 0. Therefore, this one is minus C1 square. Therefore, minus 1 square equal to minus 1. Minus CS 0. Minus CS 0. Minus S square equal to 0. Here also minus CS. C square, minus S square. So, look the formulas and substitute the corresponding values. So, there is a node 1 have 2 degrees of freedom, that is U1, V1, and node 2 have 2 degrees of freedom, U2, V2. Therefore, here we go to write down U1, V1, U2, V2 over the matrix. And simplify this AE by LE1. The value yields 28 into 10 cube. Next, for element 2, stiffness matrix for element 2. Element 2, the theta value, element 2, reference point is X2, Y2 equal to 3, 500 and 300, X3, Y3 equal to 900, 0. So, stiffness matrix for element 2, K2 equal to A2 E2 by LE2. A2 area and Young's modulus values are same for both elements, element 1 and element 2. Area equal to 200, Young's modulus equal to 70 into 10 cube. Formula for element 2 is C2 square, C2S2, C2S2 and S2 square. Then put the minus. In this row, first two values are positive, then the next two values of first row is negative. Similarly, second row, these two values are positive, therefore these two values are negative. Remaining same, C2, S2, S2 square. Similarly for column, first two values are positive, therefore next two values are negative. Second column, first two values are positive, next two values are negative. That is C2, S2, S2 square, next two values are minus C2, S2, minus S2 square. Similarly, third row, first two values are negative, therefore next two values are positive. That is first minus C2 square, minus C2 S2, C2 square, C2 S2. Similarly, second, fourth row, first two values are negative. Similarly, next two values are positive. That is minus C2 S2, minus S2 square. So C2 S2, S2 square. So first, and the equivalent length of element 2, that is LE2 equal to X3 minus X2 the whole square plus Y3 minus Y2 the whole square. Substitute the corresponding values of X3, Y3 and X2, Y2, and the value yields equivalent length of element 2 is 500 mm. Next, to find C2 and S2. Similarly, C2, S2, we have to find any one method you go to follow. Either by using theta or by using formulas, that is X3 minus X2 divided by equivalent length. So, first, here I go to teach by using theta value. So here, so look at this theta 2. So this angle equal to this angle. Actually, here we go to find this one. This one here we go to find, but with the help of this triangle, here we go to find this theta 2 value. So this theta 2. So here two values are given. One opposite side value and adjacent values are given. Therefore tan theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side is 300, adjacent side is 400. Therefore tan theta 2 equal to 300 divided by 400. Therefore theta equal to 36.87. But here there is one important. Therefore this theta value equal to 36.87. But 2 to 3 from the x axis, this is the x axis line. This x axis to this one is clockwise. Clockwise, the angle from x axis to 3, that theta is rotating clockwise direction. Therefore here we put minus 36.87 degree. So keep in your mind, when the angle tends from x axis to clockwise direction, here we put the value for theta is minus 36.87 degree. So cos theta to C2 equal to cos theta 2, that is cos minus 36.87 degree, that is C2 equal to 0.8, and S2 equal to sin minus 36.87 degree, that is minus 0.6. Because cos minus theta equal to cos theta, therefore the value is positive. Sin minus theta equal to minus sin theta, therefore S2 equal to minus 0.6. Substitute, and another one method for find C2 and S2 value is C2 equal to node 2 and node 3, therefore x3 minus x2 by equivalent length of element 2. X3 equal to 900 minus x2 equal to 500 divided by equivalent length of element 2 500. Solve this value, the value yields 0.8. S2 equal to y3 minus y2 by LE2. Y3 equal to 0 minus y2 equal to minus 300 by divided by 500. Solve this value, so the value yields minus 0.6. And substitute the all the values in the formula, that is K2 equal to A2 E2 by L E2 C2 square C2 S2 and so on. Therefore here we first for simplicity here first we find the value of C2 square. C2 square equal to 0.64, C2 S2 equal to minus 0.48, S2 square equal to 0.36. Therefore C2 square, C2 S2, C2 S2, S2 square. Then first you write these four values and change the signs. The first row, first one is positive, next one is negative. First one negative, so positive. The second row, first one is negative, therefore positive. Second one is positive, therefore next one is negative. The first column, first value is positive, therefore minus 0.34. Second value is minus 0.48, therefore next value is positive 0.48. And here we go to fill the corresponding values. Fill the all the values as per according to our formulas. And substitute all the values. Area equal to 200. Young's modulus is equal to 70 into 10 cube. Equivalent length equal to 500. Once solve this value, the value is 28 into 10 cube. Element 2 have two nodes U2 and B2. And element 3, node 2 have two nodes, 2 degrees of freedom U2, B2. And node 3 have 2 degrees of freedom U3 and B3. Therefore, here I go to write U2, B2 and U3, B3 over the matrix. Next step. Global stiffness matrix. Global stiffness matrix. Assemble stiffness matrix for element 1 and element 2. Therefore, K equal to here element 1. The coefficient value of matrix is 28 into 10 cube. Similarly, for element 2, the coefficient value of the matrix is 28. Both are same. Therefore, we put simply 28 into 10 cube. If the coefficient value is different, make it into uniform. Multiply that value inside the matrix and you can you get the similar coefficient value. So similar coefficient value only we can able to assemble two elements. Therefore next here we go to for three elements write the degrees of freedom over the global stiffness matrix U1 V1 U2 V2 U3 V3 and U1 V1 equal to. So U1 V1 equal to 1, V1 U1 equal to 0, U2 V U1 equal to minus 1, V2 U1 equal to 0. So therefore here we go to write down U1 V1 equal to 1, V1 U1 equal to 0, U2 U1 equal to minus 1, U V2 U1 equal to 0. Similarly, U1 V1 equal to 0, V1 V1 equal to 0, U2 V2 equal to 0, V2 V1 equal to 0. U1, U2 equal to minus 1. V1, U2 equal to 0. U2, U, U2 equal to plus 1. V2, U2 equal to 0. U1, V2 equal to 0. V1, V2 equal to 0. U2, V2 equal to 0. V2, V2 equal to 0. This is for element 1. But there is no value for U3, U1, V3, U1, U3, V1, V3, V1. And U1, U3, V1, V3, U1, V3, V1. Sorry, U1, U3, V1, U3, V, U1, V3, V1, V3. Therefore, similarly, here we could write the values of element 2. U2, U2. So, U2, U2 equal to 0.64. V2, U2 equal to minus 0.48. U3, U2. U3, U2 equal to minus 0.64. V3, U2 equal to 0.48. Therefore, minus 0.48. So, here we go to write the all the corresponding values from element 1 and 2. Once simplify this value, the value yields stiffness, global stiffness matrix K equal to 28 into 10 cube, and solve all the values. So, the final Truman equation can be written as F equal to Ku, where F is the force vector, K is the element stiffness matrix, and U is the displacement. So, force vector equal to at node 1, there is a two force vector F1x and F1y. At node 2, F2x, F2y, node 3, F3x, F3y, stiffness matrix, U displacement, that is U1, V1, U2, V2, U3, V3. Next step, apply the boundary conditions. Node 1 and 2 are fixed. So, come to the free body diagram. Node 1 and 2 are, sorry, node 1 and 3 are fixed. Node 1 and 3 are fixed. Yeah, node 1 and 3 are fixed, therefore node 1 we have U1, V1, node 3 are fixed, U3, V3 equal to 0. Similarly, node 1 and 3 are fixed, therefore F1x, F1y, F3x, F3y are equal to 0. Next one, F2y. So here the point load is act at node 2 in the downward direction. Point load. Now question, point load is act at node 2 in the downward direction, that is this one is F1y equal to 12 kN. In x axis there is no force is act, therefore simply F2x equal to 0, F2y equal to 12 kN. Therefore F2y equal to, it acts in the downward direction, therefore minus 12,000, that is given. F2x in the x direction, there is no force is act, therefore simply we put 0. Therefore, apply all the values in the global stiffness matrix. F1x, F1y, F2x, F2y, F3x, F3y. Global U1, V1 equal to 0. U2, V2 not equal to 0 because at point node 2, there is no fixed value. Therefore, U2, V2 not equal to 0. And U3 and V3 equal to 0. U1 equal to 0, therefore here we go to strike out the first row and first column. U V1 equal to 0, therefore here we go to strike out the second row and the second column. U3 equal to 0, that is in the fourth row, therefore fourth strike out the fourth row and fourth column. Then sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth row and fifth column. Similarly, sixth row and sixth column. The remaining values, this matrix form is transformed into the simultaneous equation form. So multiply these two matrix, this is 2 by 2 matrix, this is 2 by 1 matrix. Once multiply these two matrix, these two values, that is row into column, row into column. So 1.64 into 28 into 10 cube U2 minus 0.48 into 28 into 10 cube V2 equal to 0. That is first one. Second one similarly, row into column, minus 0.48 into 28 into 10 cube U2 plus 0.36 into 28 into 10 cube V2 equal to minus 200. So once solve these two equations, the value yields U2 equal to minus 0.571 mm, V2 equal to minus 1.95 mm. So first here we go to find the displacement of node 2, that is U2 and V2. Next, here we go to find the stress of each element. There is two element 1 and element 2. So stress induced in element 1, that is sigma 1 equal to E by L E 1 minus E 1 minus S 1 C 1 S 1 U 1 V 1 U 2 V 2. Element 1 have 2 nodes, node 1 and node 2, node 1 U 1 V 1, node 2 U 2 V 2. Substitute all the corresponding values and the value yields sigma 1 equal to 80 Newton per mm square. Stress induced in element 2, similarly sigma 2 equal to E2 by L E2, C2 minus E2 minus S2, C2 S2. Node element 2 have 2 nodes, node 2 and node 3, node 2 have U2 V2, node 3 have U3 V3. Substitute all the values and finally solve these values. The value yields sigma 2 equal to minus 99.848 Newton per mm square. Thank you.